Coding Dojo is a programming school that turns beginners into developers in only 14 weeks. If you're serious about landing a career in tech, but lack the formal education or background, Coding Dojo will get you there in no time. With over 3,000 graduates to date, over 90% of their grads land jobs within 3 months of graduating, often making over $70,000 per year at tech firms of all sizes, from companies like Google to local startups. To learn more, visit codingdojo.com or click the link in the description below.
Hey, what's up? John Sanmez here from simpleprogrammer.com. And I have a question for you about data science. Yes, I'm actually going to be talking about something programming related today. I know that shocks some of you as this channel is moving more and more away from programming topics. Oh my, what shall we ever do? To be addressed at another time. So anyway, I get this question from Aaron, and he says, I'm wondering about your thoughts on the future of data sciences and your view of it as a career path. Do you think it's a good path for a freelancer, or believe it's a path where one would generally be an employee? And lastly, do you think it's small enough of a slice to specialize in, or do you believe it's too broad of a field? Thank you in advance. So I have to admit, I am not the data scientist myself. I was just looking for my coffee. I need some coffee. But I will tell you that I have friends in data science, and it is a growing field, but it is very broad, okay? When we say data science, what do we even mean by data science, honestly? Like, it is too broad to say data science. It's sort of become a buzzword, and people like to say data sciences, but what we're really after here is doing is managing a large amount of data and doing analytics on it and manipulating that data, which is something we've been doing in the software development industry for a very, very long time. I mean, do you remember databases and cubes, right? And we've been doing this for a while, okay? We've just been doing it more, and we've had more data, and we've been working with larger volume things. And so there's been some specialization in that, things, you know, technologies like Hadoop and other data ways to visualize data technologies that have come out. I'm not going to name names of companies, but the point is this, is that it's far too broad to say that. Like, when you're asking this question, I think maybe what you're saying is, I'm interested in data and working with data. Okay, valid. Can you be an employee? Can you be a freelancer? Yes, because it's so broad, right? I mean, there's plenty of roles for any of those things. And those roles are going to diverge more as we figure out more and more of the ways, and this is just my opinion, of how we're going to deal with the huge volumes of data that we have and how we're going to process those. Then I think more specialization will evolve. But there's already specialization there, right? So what I would encourage you to do is, I would say this, data science, great. I think working with data is always going to be something, like, we're always going to have that. It's only going to grow in demand, okay? But you got to figure out what kind of data and what kind of manipulation or reporting or analytics, right? What in that realm of working with data, in that realm of data science, what are you picking out and what are you doing? And this is more important because when we say programming or software development, yes, there's a lot of differences there, but typically people say, well, at least they divide things by, I'm a C# developer, I'm a Java developer, right? I develop in PHP or Ruby, I do web development, right? We have those things. But I think in data science, it's still early enough in the evolution of this larger concept that we don't have as many of those already predefined. So it's up to you to go and figure out, how are you going to use data? How are you going to use it in your work, right? What do you want to specialize in? And you're probably going to have to pick some technologies and some tools and some ways of working with the data. That's the best thing to do, right? I mean, if you want to be the highest paid and have the highest number of options, both freelance and career-wise, what you're gonna do is, you're gonna pick a particular technology stack that you're gonna specialize in. Yes, you need a broad base knowledge, okay? But you need that, remember we talk about this T-shaped knowledge, right? Where what you're gonna need is, you're gonna need somewhere where you're gonna go deep. So pick some kind of tool. Pick some kind of data platform, right? Look in that space of working with data and see what kind of tools, what kind of things do you want to work with, what kind of technology, what kind of manipulation language for data, right? What kind of technology are you going to specialize in? And pick that and go deep there and get a real good understanding. Build a blog, right? I've got my blogging course you can check out here. and talk about it. Maybe create a YouTube channel and do YouTube channel tutorials on it, right? Specialize very deep in that specific thing, and that's gonna give you the biggest benefit. And you know, this video might as well not be about data science, because it could be about anything, right? Because this is what I tell you guys, right? I've got a whole specialization playlist, which you can check out, but you have to figure out how to specialize, how to have a deep knowledge so you can be an expert. And I've sort of upped the ante lately by saying that you should pick something that you can be number one in the world at, and you can. Everyone has an opportunity to be number one in the world at something, right? Some slice of a thing, mostly because most people won't even try. So if you just pick a small enough slice, then you can build that. And you can always branch out from there, but pick something like and just be the best. There's so many fields of study, so many points out there, so many technologies and branches of the technology that you can pick something that you can go deeper than anyone else does, or that very few people in the world go that deep. And if you have that expertise and people are using that technology, you'll be able to get a job, you'll be able to work as a freelancer, you'll be able to build your own business based on that. These are all good things, right? Being a generic special or generalist doesn't help you. So don't use data science anymore. I want you to focus and tell me exactly what kind of data scientist that you want to be, what kind of tools, what kind of technologies, what kind of data do you want to work with, even pick the industry, be that specific, and you're going to have the best outcome. All right, that's all I got for you today. If you have a question for me, you can email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com, or you can just subscribe to the channel and probably I'll eventually answer your question, because I do like 2 to 3 videos a day. All right, click the bell so you don't miss any videos. I'll talk to you next time. Take care.